Hello friends, now we will see about the context-free grammar, right? Till now we are seeing about the regular grammar and regular languages, and next one is the context-free grammar. There are four types of languages, that is type 0, type 1, type 2 and type 3, right? Regular grammar and the finite automata comes under the category of type 3. Next thing is context-free grammar. This comes under type 2 category, type 2 languages or type 2 grammars. Context-free grammars. The automata, this context-free grammars are recognized by using some push-down automata. Automata called the push-down automata. How regular languages are accepted, recognized by using finite automata? This context-free grammar or languages are accepted by using an automata called the push-down automata. Right, now we will see about the context-free grammars. Context-free grammars are defined by using some four tuples. CFG, context-free grammar, simply it is called as CFG. CFG is defined by using some four tuples. What are the four tuples means? First one is the variables, that is VTPS. V is the set of variables and T is the set of terminals and P is the set of productions and S is the start symbol. S is the only start symbol. Set of variables or non-terminals. Terminals, set of terminals, set of productions and last one is the start symbol. This is the definition for the context-free grammar. It consists of four tuples, that is V, T, P and S. Right? Consider, now we will consider the CFG for palindrome. CFG for palindrome. That is palindrome means, here set of terminals and variables means the variables can be represented by using uppercase letters. All the variables can be represented by using only uppercase letters and all the terminals are represented by using lowercase letters, numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, epsilon, all comes under the terminal category. Variables means, that is the uppercase letters, set of uppercase letters are used as the variables and terminals means it consists of lowercase letters, numbers, epsilon, all comes under the terminal category, right? And productions. How we will write the production? Productions are of the form A implies alpha. Production is of the form A implies alpha. Here A is a variable. A is a variable. Variable means that is represented by using only the uppercase letters. A is a variable. And alpha means alpha is the combination of variables and terminals. That is set of terminals and non-terminals. Set of terminals and non-terminals in any combinations, right? If example, A is capital B, is also a alpha. That is, it consists of, in the left-hand side of the production, it may consist of variables and terminals. B union T, variables and terminals. Here it is a terminal and it is a variable. But on the left-hand side of the production, always we should consist of, it should consist of a single variable. Either A, B, C, like that, it consists of only a single variable. But on the right hand side, it consists of both the variables and terminals. Right, that is B union T, the whole star. This is the production form. And next one is the start symbol. It is any symbol, the production where we are starting. How we are starting the production means by using one variable. That variable is called as the start symbol. Right, now we will see an example. Construct a CFG for palindrome. Over the alphabets or over the symbol 0, 1 whole star. That is, here we are going to use 0 and 1 as the terminals. That is, alphabets means here we are using the term as the terminals. 0 and 1 are the terminals. Right? What is palindrome? That is, the string is equal to reverse of the string. Then it is called as a palindrome. Right? So, how to construct a CFG for a palindrome? That is, the minimum possible string. First thing is, in the basis part, the minimum possible string for a palindrome cases. First thing is, epsilon. Nothing. The reverse of epsilon is also epsilon. Next one is, the first single symbol. The first case is, either 0 alone or 1 alone. Epsilon or 0 or 1. These are three basic part of the symbols for accepting the palindrome condition. Epsilon is accepting, that is, there is no symbol, so reverse is also the same. 0, reverse of 0 is same, reverse of 1 is also same. So these are the minimum symbol accepted for the palindrome condition, right? And next thing is we how to generate the n number of symbols for accepting the palindrome condition, right? Here we have to write the production that should satisfy or that should generate the symbols in a recursive manner. It is not possible to write production for each and every string, right? We have to write productions in a recursive manner. That is, we have to recursively replace or recursively generate the number of n number of symbols or n number of strings by using these productions, right? So how to write the recursive production for this palindrome case? Next condition is with modulus of w, modulus of w is equal to 1, the possible symbols of epsilon or 0 or 1. Next case is for modulus of w is equal to 2. Consider for modulus of w is equal to 2. What are the possibilities? That is, palindrome means the string is equal to the reverse of the string. That is, the first string, if you are having some string AA, BB, AA, that is, it is in palindrome. But here we are considering the symbols as 0, 1. Here, just for an example, I am saying AA, BB, AA. How people say this is in palindrome means the first symbol is equal to the last symbol. If you are writing in reverse, if you are writing in reverse means this A will comes in the first position, that is also equal to the given string. Next one, this A will come here. Next, this B, right? The reverse is also equal. That is, the first string is equal to the last string. The second string, the second symbol in the string is equal to the second symbol from the last. The third is equal to the third symbol from the last. Like this only we have to check whether this is a palindrome or not, right? So how to write the next production? How to write the next production? That is, for modulus of w is equal to 2 with the symbols as 0 and 1. That is, the symbol starts with 0 and ends with 1, right? This comes out as the category of a palindrome. Or symbol starts with 1 and ends with 1. That is, starting and ending are same symbols. Starts with 0 and ends with 0. Likewise, starts with 1 and ends with 1. This comes under the category of palindrome. Two more possible symbols with modulus of w is equal to 2. But that should not come under the palindrome. That is 0, 1 and 1, 0. This will not be a palindrome. This will not be a palindrome. So the palindrome conditions are strings are 0, 0 and 1, 1. Right? 0, 0 and 1, 1. But we should not write the productions with S implies 0, 0 and S implies 1, 1. We have to write the productions in a recursive way. Recursive way means that same production has to satisfy for modulus of W is equal to 3, modulus of W is equal to 4, modulus of W is equal to 5. Then how we will write the production? The first productions are S implies epsilon, S implies 0 and S implies 1. These are the three productions that satisfy the basic part of the condition. Next thing is S implies, that is 0, 0 or 1, 1, right? So we will write this as 0, S, 0 or 1, S, 1. 0, S, 0 or 1, S, 1. The string starts with 0 and ends with 0. Likewise, starts with 1 and ends with 1. In between, this S can be replaced by using either by epsilon or by 0 or by 1. If you are replacing this S by using epsilon means, then what will happen? That is equal to 0, 0. If S is replaced by epsilon means, the string is equal to 0, 0. If S is replaced by 0, it is equal to triple 0. If S is replaced by 1, it is equal to 0, 1, 0. Right? Here, if this S is replaced by epsilon means 1, 1. By 0 means 1, 0, 1. By 1 means that is equal to triple 1. Now all the strings are comes under the category of palindrome. Right? So if we want to generate the symbols with modulus of W is equal to 4. Here we generated the string with modulus of W is equal to 3. If we want to generate the string of modulus of W is equal to 4 means S implies 0, S, 0. This S can be replaced by again by 0, S, 0. This S is replaced by 0, S, 0. Already we are having this 0. Now this S is replaced by 0, S, 0. So 0, 0, yes, 0, 0. If S is replaced by 0 or 1 or epsilon, right? If you are replacing this by epsilon means modulus of W is equal to 4. Replacing either by 0 or by 1 means then modulus of W is equal to 5. Again, instead of that, if you are replacing S by this S by 1s1, S implies 1s1. If you are using this production here means 0, 0, this S is replaced by 1s1. Again, you are having 0, 0, right? So 3 plus 3, 6 symbols. If S is replaced by either by 0 or 1 means then modulus of W is equal to 7, right? Like this, we will generate the string, that is strings W. Modulus of W is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like that by using recursive productions. We have to write the productions in a recursive way. We should not write specific production for each and every input symbol. Only the specific production is for the basic condition. That is modulus of W is equal to 1. For that only we have to write the specific production. Other than that, we have to write the productions in a recursive way. Right? Thank you.